Hey, ET from CNC at home. You know, I was going through the old internet looking at some YouTube videos on cutting tiles and that sort of thing. Kind of into cutting tiles, it seems, these days. Anyway, I came across a couple things I wanted to give a try. One was just putting the tile in the laser and cutting it. No paint on it, nothing. And apparently you do that, and then you take a Sharpie marker and you cover the whole tile with the Sharpie, and then you clean it off with just isopropyl alcohol. It does something apparently to the coating on the tile, the kind of the glazing that's on there. I gave it a try, and that's what we'll see in the video. I won't bore you with the white tile being cut by the laser and it just looks white. I'll show a little bit of it, and then we'll get to kind of the conclusion to see how that worked. But it's a very interesting process, has some potential, so I'll do some more experimenting with it after this, I'm sure. Well, after burning the tile with several different settings, it didn't really cut through the enamel like I thought it was going to do. So in a few spots that you can see highlight here, it actually did burn through just a little bit. And I took a Sharpie, marked in on the black ones. I took a green marker and a blue marker marked in there. And where the enamel was etched away, the ink soaked right into the tile. And when I cleaned it off, it stayed, which is kind of cool. Just the laser isn't strong enough to really consistently cut through this, so that's not a viable solution. What I did find, though, as I was cleaning this off, is all the stuff that I burned on here was still there. I doubt you're going to be able to see this. Let's just try it. I don't know if you can see that at all. But you can see just a little bit in person, and where the laser cut, it doesn't fog up quite the same. And when I was cleaning off the Sharpie marker from that, it was on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover this in Sharpie marker again and then clean it off, but not get so aggressive, so you can see what I'm talking about. Hang on a second. Okay, that should be enough. I didn't do the whole tile, but I just did some of it. Now I'm going to get some just regular rubbing alcohol and clean that area off, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Have some just regular old isopropyl alcohol, and I got some toilet paper because that will work for what we need. And we'll just get this wet down with some isopropyl, and then I'll just start cleaning this off. And as I clean it, can you see that now? Isn't that weird? So there's actually this stuff on there, and I could clean a little bit harder over here, I guess, where I know there's nothing I want to keep. It says 40 at 100, 30 at 100, 20 at 100. Now, you can see some other zeros in there, because I also did a 200 at, I don't know if it was 100 maybe, hard to tell. Here it says 100 at 100. So I was trying different feeds and speeds. Here's 50 at 100. Now, 50 at 100. Down here, it actually, the zero burned through, part of the at burned through, a little bit of the one and the zero burned through, right through the coating. But 40 at 100, so it's even slower, didn't get through. 50 at 100 did, 40 didn't. So it must be something with the inconsistencies of the coating on the tile. Who knows? But it did do this other funky thing. So There are people who have done this method, and it's turned out real nicely. So I'm thinking if I just spend a little time playing around, I might be able to get something worthwhile. So anyway. Not bad. I'll maybe try a picture or something. That's what the other people did. So that there's not much point. Anyway, we'll give it a try.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.